very much. So you can see a big difference from the winter concert. Fourth grade band's going to continue with the next piece. It's called Gesture Dance, and it's a really fun piece. Fun to play and also fun to listen to. It's going to start with a percussion introduction. Our clarinet section is going to have a little solo, and then the rest of the band comes in, and then each little section kind of has a little one bar with a solo. So it's a really neat little piece. This is called Gesture Dance.
Thank you.
another round of applause for our soloists. Before we go into our next song, I want to recognize a couple of students, a few students in the band who are playing instruments in addition to what they do in concert band as well. Our two piano players also play instruments in the concert band. So on piano, our piano players for this tune is going to be Alex Chow. So he plays piano on this, and he also plays trombone in the concert band. So let's recognize Alex. And our piano player on Hog's Breath Cafe, she plays trumpet in concert band, but she plays piano there at Hog's Breath Cafe, is Anna Zahorchak. And our guitar player, actually, he just started with us just doing guitar, and then he liked us so much in band that he decided he wanted to pick up the trombone. So he started the trombone actually sort of like the second half of the year, and he's making great progress, and is actually going to be doing trombone next year at Ingemar Middle as well. And that's our guitarist, Jake Bryce. Jasmine has one more piece that we're going to play for you, and this one is a blues, in a blues style. It's called A Blues to Grow In. You're going to hear some more solos. You're going to hear a flute solo by Olivia Carlson, saxophone solo by Stephen Zhao, a trombone solo by Evan Greenberg, and he's improving this one, right? Very cool. And then trumpet solos by Max Adams and Max McCarron, and a guitar solo by Jake Frank. This is A Blues to Grow In. going to change styles completely. And this next piece is in more of a lyrical style. It's slower. And this kind of music is really challenging for us because as band students, you know, fast and loud, we like to do that, and we can do that. But playing slow music really requires them a lot of concentration on their part and thinking about phrasing and balance and when to bring out your part because it's the melody and when to put it in the background. Phrasing and watching together, watching the conductor for where to breathe. So there's a lot of really tricky elements in this. And I really think this is a pretty piece. And it's written by Brian Baumage, who writes fabulous music for all levels of band and orchestra as well. But yeah, I really think he especially writes really great music for a beginner band. And you'll see that even though this is a piece for a beginning band, it really has a mature sound, and it gives them a chance to play in a very lyrical style. This is Midnight Sky. Before we go into our next piece, I just want to recognize a couple of students that were selected to participate in the PMEA District 1 Elementary Honors Band. This was a band festival that was actually just last week, and it was at Carlington High School, which is on the other side of the world as far as we're concerned, not in Carnegie, PA. And they rehearsed all day on Friday, and then on Saturday performed at a concert. This was 5th and 6th grade students. From not just from North Allegheny, but also from all over Allegheny County. So it was a really cool experience event. So I have a certificate. I just want to recognize those students and have certificates for them. So Max Adams, please come on up. Thank you. And Evan Greenberg. Fifth grade has one more piece that we're going to do for you before we do our combined finale. And this one is, I told you earlier, one of the most important styles of music in the concert band repertoire is marches. And fourth grade got to do a march, so fifth grade is going to do their march now. And this is really cool because it's based on a piece of concert band music. It's probably one of the most important pieces of concert band music in the band repertoire. And that's Gustav Holst's First Suite for Military Band. And it's really innovative because it's one of the first pieces that somebody wrote specifically for a concert band, or a military band as they called it back then. It wasn't written for orchestra first. And if you have any classical music fans out there, you may know, recognize that Gustav Holst wrote a lot of pieces. Probably his most famous thing that he wrote was The Planets, which you might have heard the Pittsburgh Symphony perform that before. But this is a march based on one of the movements from that suite, so it's kind of cool. It's a really nice connection for them to make to really standard concert band repertoire. And perhaps at some point further in their career, I know the NAI Wind Ensemble just played the full version of this, but at some point in their band career, they may end up actually playing the real first suite. So this is March from First Suite for Military Band.